So we're going to have a go at creating some more complex shapes. So we created a rocket in the last video. We're going to use a tool called extrude here to pull out shapes. It's quite similar to if you've done some CAD work in maybe like SketchUp before. Okay, so we're going to start with a cube first of all. So you can either put one in or use the default one that's there. And what we're going to do is we're going to just flatten it first of all. Okay. So we could use the scale tool here and just use the blue z-axis to kind of flatten it so it looks roughly around that. Don't worry if you haven't got it like 100% exact, that's absolutely fine. So from here, what we're going to do is we're going to go into, rather than object mode, edit mode, so we can start editing the actual elements of the object. And we're going to use a tool called loop cut. Okay, so it's just here, or you can press Control and R on the keyboard. Okay, so if we do that, what we get is this kind of yellow box here. And when you see that, if you just click and drag, okay, so we get the sort of orange line roughly in this case about there. Okay, and we can click to place it. All right. So what this is going to do, this is going to divide up our cube into different sections. And what we're going to do is we're going to build a little stool, okay, a little chair with it. So this is going to form part of the leg, and you'll see as the video goes on how this works. So I'm going to get another loop cut, okay, and there it is. And I'm going to drag it roughly the other side, okay. And then I'm going to get another one, a third one. And I'm just going to position it. Can you see, if you move your mouse, it will position the other direction this time. So rather than that direction, it's now that direction. And if you then click, and we want to position it around about there. Okay. And then we want a fourth one. This will be the final one. Same thing, we're going to drag it. So we position it about there. Okay. So I haven't measured this too well, but roughly you're going to have something that looks like that. Okay, so split up like that with the different loop cuts. Just use Control Z if it's not quite right and you can redo it. Okay, that's not a problem. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to now go underneath the object. Okay. And we've got these four corners, which are going to be the legs of the chair. Okay. Now, to make these the legs, we need to go up into the face selection mode at the top left here. And we're going to need to hold down Shift on the keyboard. And I'm just going to click each of these corners here. And they're going to become the legs, okay? And a bit like in CAD, we'd use the push-pull tool to pull those down to make the legs. We're going to use the extrude tool here, okay? So we're just going to press E on the keyboard. And that will pull down the legs with your mouse, okay? So use your mouse, pull them down to wherever you want to be. Okay, so roughly around there is fine. And now we just need to make the back of the chair. So what I'm going to do is I am going to, you can do this in a couple of different ways, but again, we're making sure the face select mode is on. I'm going to hold down Shift and I'm going to select the two corners. And same thing, I'm going to press E and pull them up to extrude. Okay, we're going to select that. I think when I used the previous tool, the loop cut tool, I think I must have done it slightly wrong. Can you see that? Because it's pulling up the sort of other side there. Okay, that's okay. I'm just going to leave it like that for now. Okay, so we got the back of the chair. Now you can sort of then do a couple of things from here. We could, for example, just unselect the tops that we had there, and I could select that, so holding down Shift and clicking, and then I could kind of extrude that across to make the back of the chair.